Well, people in Bemidji are frustrated after a bonding bill recently failed to pass at the state capitol. A number of projects have been left in the dust, including several in the region. Jackson Bruner has more.
I really think right now it's a failure in leadership.
Minnesota's bonding bill failure in recent months has left this city councilor frustrated.
They really had no other goals they had to get, they needed to get done, and they still couldn't pass what they typically do every other year.
His alma mater, Bemidji State University, hoped to use $18 million to spearhead a major change, replacing Hagsauer Hall.
It wasn't even included on the final bonding bill project. It was unfairly skipped over, in my opinion.
A building that they say is outdated.
When the water table goes up, we do have some water that is standing in the lower basement level.
They also say the building is too large, and if rebuilt on a smaller scale, it would focus on using technology for group projects.
Different tables will be set up with monitors that the faculty member will be controlling. They'll be like displaying their work. It's the flip classroom environment, where projects will be done versus lecturing will be done.
There's also the Northern Dental Access Center, a facility that can barely handle the crowd it serves.
Since about 2 years ago, we reached our limits to how we can expand in this current facility, which is leased. And yet the demand for dental care among folks enrolled in Medicaid continues to rise in the region, and we're seeing more and more people coming from outlying communities.
They're ready to expand. It's investment in public health, and It was in the final bonding bill project, and again, that's a project that could be happening right now.
In total, Minnesota has over $900 million to spend, and with no call for a special session yet from state leaders, everyone is waiting with bated breath.
I think the governor and the Speaker of the House and the Senate Majority Leader need to get together and make these projects happen for all of Minnesota.
In the near term, we'll just continue to see patients as much as we can and be as efficient as possible.
We will still keep this as our BSU priority number one, meaning that if there is a bonding bill in 2017, we'll pursue it then. If not, we'll continue to pursue it for 2018.
Money for renovations to Red Lake Elementary School was also included in bonding bill talks. Lakeland News was unable to reach district officials for comment.
If you've enjoyed this segment of Lakeland News, please consider making a tax-deductible contribution to Lakeland Public Television.